to New York City inside of the NBA 2K League Studios, and there it is, the first game of the night. And woo, it was a close one. Goes down to the wire. Pistons GT gets the one-point win over the Bucks, 57-56. Will come high above here, Larry Ridley and Dirk. And Dirk, you look at that, man. What a finish it was, the last 108. It was tied at 53. Larry gets the big block, hits only one of two free throws. And then you go down the strike. Romo a bucket. Larry a dunk. Insanity, the last bucket at 11.7 seconds left. The Pistons got a steal, gave the ball back to the Bucks, and then they missed that final shot. Oh, you got to feel bad if you're the Bucks. 1-4 now in the season. They talked about it before the game, Dirk. It's all mental with these guys to close out games. Once again, they come up short.
Yeah, it's unfortunate for both teams when you look at the stretch that happened with Pistons GT. We started the game back up. A three went way of Bucks gaming. So, and then that's where the players on Pistons GT, they got a little bit deflated. And then as we go deeper into that one, the big crucial turning point and what won them that game was the missed shot coming in from Rux. Ramo was right there on the offensive boards. They led Insane to get that score. That's where it started to go south. And then Bucks gaming on the inbounds. They had Meek over towards the corner. The timeout was going to be called on the inbounds, as you said. The ball was stolen. He ran out of bounds. And that's where it's almost like, okay, this is fate. We got to be able to hit this one. And you shoot the fadeaway, it's not going to be the best shot, especially when you're going to be on that sharp shooting rim protector. It's not something that you want. Now, if you have somebody with a shot creating in that build, maybe it would be possible for the centers and power forwards. We're not going to have that one that's going to be able to use in the arsenal, too. So it's just unfortunate. I think it was just one of those situations where you're running. You have to kind of pause there for a second to be able to actually get your jump shot animation instead of shooting the fadeaway. So it's sort of that momentum carries on, but you got to stop it. You got to plant your feet. But with only 2 seconds on the clock, that's not – if you sit there and try to plant your feet, then you get a rush shot animation. Then you're not going to make it. That's where it's completely up to a gamble, but a hell of a game played between both these sides.
Here we go. Highlights. Pistons GT, they pull it out dirt by 157-56.
And both these teams, like we said, you look at these sides and you don't look at this one as any of these teams as being really hardcore three-point shooters,
there
right? These are guys that like to
right there, that came up short.
They love to brute force their way into the paint. They love to get their buckets within the arc, so they don't really like to step out too much. You don't have anybody on the other side who can hit on that consistent basis. So it really just came to, like we said, the team that's getting the stops and getting those buckets after getting those stops, that's how you end up winning that game. We said that once Bucks Gaming, they ended up tying the game up. That was because they were getting those stops. Every single time they got a stop, they got a score. There was three possessions in a row where they did it, and that kind of like propelled them into it. And then going into that fourth quarter, it was just a back and forth battle going down low. You start to see everybody getting to the mix. So they had a fadeaway three, which I believe was hit by Peroxide, and that's one of those ones where you kind of sit there still. It's like, wow, how did he make that one? Like, everyone states it like, no way. Like, how did this just happen as well?
Pistons GT, they moved to 2-0 in the regular season. Hey, it was a rematch of the first ever inaugural game here in the inaugural season of the NBA 2K League in the tip-off, and it was Pistons getting the win 49-44. They get another W over Bucks game, and let's go downstairs to the Intel caster desk. Scott is standing by with one of the winners. Scott?
Yeah, yeah!